Hello and welcome to the YouTube channel by Online Excel Tip. I am Anil Dhawan and I want to tell you that we are coming up with a video series of Excel data validation feature in which we will be telling you the use of data validation from basics like what is data validation rules, working with input and error messages, how to apply data validation, creating drop-down lists using multiple methods to the advanced level like creating dependent drop-down lists, working with dynamic drop-down lists, restricting user to enter numbers, text, email IDs, unique values or stop users to enter duplicate values in the range or applying custom formulas and many other real-life situations. So, here is the quick look of similar examples we would be taking in this video series. Let's say, you want to have a number in the cell between specific range. So you can use data validation feature to have the same. Or you may want to have the date in cell within next 7 days. So today is 14th of February 2018. So if I try to enter date within 7 days, say for I enter here 20th February 2018, I can easily enter that. But if I try date outside the range, I won't be allowed because I have applied data validation in this cell. Or you may want to have a simple drop-down list of status, remarks or items, and you can use data validation for the same. You can also have a cell containing options to pick up the periods like year, quarter, month, week, and basis on the value of this cell, you want your next cell to display the quarter. Or maybe you select month, then it would display the month's name, or you select here week, it's going to display the week series. Or you may prevent users from entering duplicate values in the range. So here we have the list of few fruits name, and if we try to enter any fruit name which is already there in the list, bingo, here immediately we can see the error message and says you are trying to enter the fruit name which is already there in the list, try any other fruit name. We have customized the error message, and when we click on retry, it would take us back into the edit mode of the cell and we would be asked to enter any other fruit name, and when we enter in a unique name, we would be able to enter it successfully. So data validation is one of the greatest feature to be used in all such situations. You can also suggest me if you want to have a video for any particular situation to use data validation in Excel. You may add this series to your playlist or share it with your family, friends and colleagues. Subscribe us to get regular updates. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the first video of data validation series. Have a great day.